do have team coverage on this big story. KOCO's Kim Passoff is in Bricktown with reaction there. Kim.
Well, Paul and Jessica, the shops in Bricktown sell OSU clothing. The Sonic even sells this OSU burger. But now the beloved football team has been thrust into a negative national spotlight, and it's casting a shadow on all of Oklahoma.
Shocking, definitely shocking.
It's just kind of crazy.
It's not good. Not good for the state.
We let people read Sports Illustrated's accusations for themselves. The list raised more than a few eyebrows. OU student Megan Sterling says even though OSU is a rival school, she's disappointed to learn of the allegations.
They're pretty extreme. I mean, drug use and the money that's involved. I think that's just outrageous, a little too much.
I know stuff like that goes on, but I was surprised.
OSU fan Colin Spryer says he feels like his Cowboys were singled out.
I mean, you could probably pick any school and find the same stuff.
But says he thinks the allegations must now be looked into.
If they did something wrong, then it should get flushed out and maybe the whole, you know, industry can change.
And even if the allegations prove true, OSU fans like Colin say they won't let that troubled past define the future.
Will you still be a fan after this?
Definitely.
And tonight, the Oklahoma Cowboy fan football page has this message. They're saying, regardless of what people write, we stand united. Hashtag I ride with the Cowboys. Let's make that the name of our discussion on social media. Live in Bricktown, Kim Passoff, KOCO 5 News.
And Kim, our coverage of this big story doesn't stop here.
Yeah, head over to KOCO.com to watch Athletic Director Mike Holder's comments on the allegations. And we've also posted an outline of the Sports Illustrated report. And be sure to join us tomorrow at 8 a.m. on our live wire when that story breaks. It's right before Sports Illustrated releases its very first article.